Mark Zero's XCOM The Long War. Let's play.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to The Long War. I am Mark Zero, and we have an alien crash site. I almost said alien abduction. We have a UFO crash site in Mexico to get to. You'll notice we've run the clock down to 20 hours. So let's show you what happened in that process. I ran the clock down in order to get Karmic Castaway and Montgomery Payson back from fatigue. In the meantime, if I take a look at the research archives, we have completed alien computers. So that gave us the satellite Nexus, as well as the option for a new research project, Alien Biocybernetics. Alien Biocybernetics equals mechs. So I definitely want to make that a priority. However, I am going to deviate again, and I am going to do interrogate Muton. Interrogating Muton gives us the Gauss weapon credit. We will be moving into Gauss weapon shortly. Actually, now that I'm talking this out, let's see. Seeker autopsy would be useful. We're almost into a respectable point on Illyrium, which is nice. Advanced aerospace concept, that is soon, but I want to try to get a floater autopsy coming, which means alien biocybernetics. Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and do that. We do want scout fairly soon, but I'm going to spend the next days on alien biocybernetics. That gives us the option of beginning to build mechs. It will also give us floater stuff, which is important. So we're going to begin that project, and let's take a look at the foundry real fast. Alien grenades needs $100. So we are going to do alien grenades after this mission. So that is my plan. Anyway, back to business. We have a squad ready in the hangar to deal with this crash site. Let's go ahead and review who we've got going out on this mission. Alrighty. So this is another mix of low and high levels. We are bringing two rookies on this mission because the idea here is that I want to try and train up as many rookies as possible on missions that I have the chance to do it. So we've also got a couple of faces of people who have not been here in a while. And first among those is Joe Z. Joe Z went down from a critical wound and almost died on a previous operation. He's been out for about a month, but Joe is back. Joe did take a will hit, so he's down at 43 will. Joe is one of our heat gunners, but has not gone very far. Zhang is the better of the two heat gunners that I have right now. But Joe Z is going to be, you know, attempting to follow that pattern. Armor-piercing ammo and a scope, as well as Carapace armor, and the auto laser. So Joe is actually very close to level. We are going to try to push him over that edge and make up for a little bit of lost time on him. 21st Century Fool, we have not seen in a very long time. He was one of our rookies, or she, rather, was one of our rookies, who went out on one mission, did not get any kills, did not level. So we are going to try to finish that one off and maybe punch into Specialist a little bit at the rookie rank. Both of the rookies on this mission are loaded out the same way. Laser rifle, alloy plating, scope, in order to try and get kills. 21st Century Fool has decent aim, one extra point of health, terrible move, might be a gunner. Might be a good candidate for a gunner, because gunners generally tend to be okay with terrible move. We'll see. Karmic Castaway is why we ran the clock forward. I was thinking about fatiguing her, but I decided it was a better idea to just run the extra couple of hours and get her back. Laser sniper rifle, laser pistol, phalanx armor, scope, alloy plating, because, oh my god, the health is so low. The health is so, so low. Low enough that I'm afraid to put Kestrel on Karmic Castaway. And it doesn't make sense to use Kestrel on this map anyway, because we are dealing with heavy vegetation in a forest. So the grappling hook is sort of limited use. I mean, there's some places where you can use it, but not that great. Anyway, one of our carries on this one is Scoopy. Scoopy is at Sergeant rank, working on getting to Tech Sergeant. Should be able to pop this mission if we're lucky. Loaded up with a laser rifle, a battle scanner. Has the battle scanner perk as well, so this means that these are three battle scanners. Laser rifle, flashbang grenade. The flashbang grenade is in case we run into any mutons. Not mutons, rather, but in case we run into any berserkers, because that is possible, that may happen. Montgomery Payson is commanding this mission. Monty has a scatter laser, laser pistol, alloy plating, and a motion tracker. Monty is the tank. Monty is sitting comfortably at, this is 15 health. Math is not my strong suit. Monty is going to be pushing the line along with Scoopy, who, well, Scoopy's got 11. Scoopy doesn't have alloy plating. So those two are going to push the line. Josie is going to hold the line down. Sean Devlin, whom I just realized before turning on the camera that I did not pick an ability. It's between Mayhem and Battle Scanner. I'm going to go with Battle Scanner because I did not pick Suppression. Even though Sean is a grenading engineer, Repair leads him to be something of a support. As I talk this out, I want to take Battle Scanner because I'd like to have an engineer with Battle Scanner. It doesn't make much sense on this mission to have two people running with extra Battle Scanners. Let's see. Packmaster is happening either way at Gunnery. Tandem Warheads or Bombard. You know what? I'm going to go with Mayhem. I'm going to go with the extra grenade damage. We will confirm that. Would have been better if I had Suppression and Mayhem. But I'll take Repair and Mayhem. Anyway, Sean has not been with us for a while because in the same mission we almost lost Josie, we almost lost Sean Devlin. Sean went on a just, you know, balls-to-the-wall tear to try and save Josie's life and actually pulled it off, to my surprise, because I thought I was going to get him killed. But Sean is loaded up with a laser rifle, an arc thrower because Repair, and HE grenades to try and destroy cover. Sean is a little bit of a weird engineer build, as you could see by the fact that I could not pick an ability offhand, and I was thinking about taking Battle Scanner. I'm thinking it's going to be, it's now Mayhem. I'm thinking it's going to be Packmaster instead of Extra Con. And then I can either do Tandem Warheads in order to have a cover destruction engineer that can just throw a grenade and cover destroy, or Bombard if I want to stay more at range. It's probably going to be Tandem because I have Repair and because Sean tends to close in, but we will get to that when we come to it. Lube Stapler is our medic for this mission, armed with a laser rifle, two med kits, and a smoke grenade. Only at Lance Corporal, so all we have so far is Field Medic and Field Surgeon. Lube is looking to get another level out of this mission, and I believe I'm making Lube a doctor on this one, so Lube will be another medic that is capable of doing battlefield revives and things like that. Last but not least, our last rookie is Coffin Jack. Jack was not brought on prior missions, despite the fact that Jack has been a recruit since the beginning of the XCOM project. This is the first time I've deployed him. I've delayed it because Jack's stats are kind of garbage. 3 health and 11 move, which are the minimums, pretty much. 66 aim, which is sort of decent, middle of the line. The big thing here is 40 will. Coffin Jack took will as a dump stat really, really hard. Might end up being a medic, because medics have substantial will progression. Might end up being something else that just does not need to push the line. Aim's not high enough to be a sniper, so that's out. The main thing here with Coffin Jack is that 40 will means whatever I make him, he is going to be psychic. Oh man, is he going to be psychic. And that's one of the reasons why I'm considering medic, is because I can make him like the ultimate psychic medic. But we will see what happens with that. That is our squad for this mission. Hopefully this will not be too difficult, because we did shoot the UFO down, but we are seeing berserkers and mechtoids now, so anything goes here. Let's see what we can do. Let's go ahead and, looks like, what are we on, the Baja Peninsula? Let's hit the Baja Peninsula. Let's have a little beach party with a crashed UFO. Here we go.
We're going to be putting down in Mexico for this mission. The bogey came down hard in a remote area just outside of a small town. We should deploy and eliminate any hostiles at the crash site.
Okay, Operation Devil's Dream. I think this is the burning forest with the truck on it. Again, the forest maps I kind of just play by sight. I don't know them all by hand or anything like that. But anyway, let's get down there. Let's see what we can do about securing this crash site.
Strike one is clear to attempt the breach.
Alright, looks like we're in a corner on this one, which means we can either move out this way or down this way. Either way, I think we secure this front area as an initial beachhead, and we can probably install Karmic Castaway up behind this low cover once we know that this side's clear. I was gonna say there's no way that's the edge of that map. It's probably going to be moving this way. I think the alien craft will be over by that tree there. But I'm not going to give up the slightly elevated cover just yet. Let's see, who can get to that tree? Alright, looks like Scoopy. So Scoopy is going to do his job.
Roger, tracking.
Alright. And Scoopy does have a lot of battle scanners, so we're going to try. You know what? I'm going to just throw right out down here and see what's in this area right off the bat. In fact, I'm going to throw it. All right, there's the truck. So let's see what's around the truck.
Eyes in the sky.
Okay. All right, so we're reasonably clear over by this truck, and now I kind of know what map we're on. The UFO is going to be over here. I'm thinking we secure this side, and then we start thinking about what we're going to do. Alrighty. Let's see, now Coffin Jack. These are the guys that I need to be careful about, the rookies. I'm thinking Joe Z up to here.
Time to motor.
Alright, and that's our front line. Everybody else is going to actually stand in the open, but we're going to stand in the open behind the line that we just drew for ourselves. Karmic Castaway, I am going to place here and steady my weapon. Alright. And I think it's okay to stand out of cover here.
Affirmative.
Because we can scramble for it next turn and we're not going to activate. I am going to put Coffin Jack in this cover. Lube Stapler, central to everybody. And 21st Century Fool, why don't you get up here? Alright, and this will be an Overwatch. Overwatch. Coffin Jack, I'm gonna have you steady your weapon. Monty, Overwatch, shouldn't be a big deal. Alright, let's see if we get any audio cues. Absolutely nothing, which means we're closest to the outsider. Or we're just not close to anything. Alright. Scoopy. Scoopy and Monty are my eyes, basically, right now. Alright, nothing there. I'm gonna run out to here.
Obstacles.
Nothing. Alright, let's move it to this high cover. Alright. So now we can start thinking about Well, this is what we want to reveal, basically. All right, let's start moving it up.
Solid copy.
And again, I think we can basically put everybody against this line.
Location.
Good. I probably should have put Sean a little bit closer to the front. I will do this with lube stapler.
Position confirmed.
Alrighty. Now we could still get hit from that side. 21st century fool.
On my way.
On that log. It's big, it's heavy, and it is in fact wood. Coffin Jack.
Position confirmed.
Unfortunately, you're gonna have to stand over there. Not your best place to stand, actually. I could get you up there, but that could pull. And Karmic Castaway.
Aye, aye, Commander.
I'm gonna keep you with the group for now. And steady your weapon. Let's see. 21st Century Fool, steady your weapon. Lube Stapler, steady your weapon. Everybody else, Overwatch, Overwatch. Pointless Overwatch, not so pointless Overwatch. Alright, no audio cue, but we did get an indication that we're moving somewhat in the right direction. But no audio cue, which means we're moving somewhat in the right direction of the outsider, more likely than not. And that will make this mission dicey, if we catch the outsider first. I am going to keep proceeding, though. Nothing. Alright. I'm going to move it up to here. And we are going to start reorienting to go this way. Which means, Monty, I'm going to put you down center to that tree. That's not Monty, that's Josie. Alright, Josie, you're on this tree. Where is Monty? Monty, you're on this tree. Alright, I know we're spread a little bit, we're gonna collapse somewhat. Karmic Castaway, I am gonna place you here and steady your weapon. Alright, everybody else, let's see, Sean Devlin, I want in a good grenade throwing position. 21st Century Fool. Let's see, what can Coffin Jack get to? Coffin Jack can't get to anything that good, so I'm gonna move you up to here. Whereas 21st Century Fool can be here, and that can be a steady weapon. And Lube Stapler. I'm gonna have you hunker it. Actually, no, you're the only Overwatch I got. Alright. Now, the difficult part is we need to attempt to cross no man's land here. And hilariously, we were moving towards Meld. Alright, Scoopy. I'm going to do something a little dangerous. Clear. Scoopy, you are going across no man's land by yourself.
That's what we're looking for.
Alright, we have Meld. Let's go try to secure it. Monty, you're the other side. Clear. I have a feeling we're not going to have a lot of contact at all on this map. Alright, Joe, you're up to the car. Now, the rookies are going to hang back. Sean Devlin, I'm going to have you up to the car as well. The rookies will provide the long-range overwatch. Well, Fool won't. Fool's gonna provide the get-over-here overwatch. Lube Stapler, you... I'm gonna stand you in the open, believe it or not. Because it's better than running up to that truck. Coffin Jack, you're on Overwatch. Hermit Castaway, There's a lot of trees in here now. This might be the best sight line for where we're going. Keep it steady. Finally, another audio cue. Alright, I'm not getting any kind of growls or anything, so that's the outsider, and we might just have to aggro the outsider. Alright. So, Scoopy, your job is not the meld. Monty, your job is gonna be the meld. Scoopy, your job is gonna be to get out to here. Clear. All right. Seekers. Three of them. That also explains why we didn't hear anything. Four of them. I thought Seekers made some kind of like a rustling noise. All right. Well, the bad news here is that I don't think we can really get to these Seekers. Monty, you're gonna move up. Now, I could run and gun to here. It leaves the possibility of these Seekers running up and flanking. Josie, I want you overwatching from here. Sean Devlin, you're gonna be on overwatch from here. Alright. Now, Lube Stapler can't quite get to where I want him to be. What I wanted him to do was I wanted him to be able to, like, get to here on a blue move. So, kind of wish I had run all the way up to this rock like I originally planned. But, instead we'll do this.
Roger. Got my eyes on.
I'm pretty sure that meld is gonna last one more turn.
Moving to designated position.
Alright. Karmic Castaway has a shot at one of them, and it's a pretty good one. Let's go with it. One down, not bad. That leaves three. And Karmic Castaway earns a promotion as well. Alright, 21st Century Fool, you're moving up. And Monty. It's a somewhat futile Overwatch, but you're gonna take it. Alright. They're rolling to flank. And Scoopy's panicking. Alright, not a lot we can do about that. Stealth mode. And we can assume the other one's probably in stealth mode. Okay. Well, this is unfortunately the gamble that you take sometimes when you move people on gold moves. I accept that. Let's see. Josie. Can Monty see it? Monty can see it, which means you can see it if you move up to here. Or not, because line of shite. Monty, what can you see? Alright, well, if Monty can see it, can we snipe it? 57 isn't great. Scoopy is our holo targeting, so that's unfortunate. We're most likely gonna cover Scoopy in smoke. Sean Devlin. Move it up to here. Alright, we have visual on two of them. 51, 51. This is an overwatch, so it's lucky that we didn't move up further.
That's affirmative.
Jack, you're gonna be on overwatch.
Aye.
Now, what I could do here is I could grab that meld It might be running an overwatch, though. My logic is I could grab the meld and then run to here and try to take that guy. Karmic Castaway now has two shots. They're both even. The other thing we need to keep in mind here is that Karmic Castaway may be the strangle target. So we can't overcommit to the two we can see. It's a really, really a shame that Josie can't see anything from here. Alright. This might have to be a run and gun rapid fire. I can get up to here. Yeah, this is gonna have to be a run and gun rapid fire because we need to take out the one that has Scoopy flanked. Okay. 57. I'm gonna rapid fire it, see what happens. Good. Nah, it was low chances. Alright. You're the bigger problem, so I'll take this 57. Karmic Castaway rocking the house. Okay. Now, if we can take out this one, that would be good. I'll take a little bit of damage on it. 21st Century Fool, I am going to run you backward because there's a good chance Karmic Castaway is about to be strangled. So I'm actually going to run you away from the action and overwatch. Let's see. Loop Stapler, you're going to throw smoke. I can only get two people in it. Actually, he's hunkered, so he doesn't really need smoke anymore. And he's moving that way. And firing at Monty. Which I'm fine with, because Monty's built to be fired at. We got a lot of movement. And we have Scoopy back. Scoopy can hollow target that thing. Scoopy can also grab the meld while hollow targeting that thing.
Got it.
Awesome. That's 16 more meld. Joe, can you roll up and maybe see this guy from here? Or can you... Let's see. We know... Alright. Sean Devlin can't see him from there. Scoopy can see him from there. Not sure where Loop Stapler can see from. Karmic Castaway needs to dislodge. Plain and simple. Because she is probably going to be shot at by a Seeker. We don't want to physically run to the ship because that will pull the outsider. And I want to throw a flash, battle scanner and see where this other one is. So I will do that now. And if necessary, I can command for the holo targeting. There we go. He was going to grab Sean. Not anymore, he's not. Because we have 100% and 50 to critical. I'm even going to take the first shot with Sean. Oh, it's a kill. That defeated what I was going to do.
Bye-bye.
Sean, you stole the kill. We were trying to get the kill on somebody else. You done gone and stole the kill.
Got it covered.
On the bright side, we can see him from here. We got an 84 to hit on the flush. Now, Monty could maybe take a shot with the pistol. It's 32 from this range. Let's move it up. Alright, good. 55. What's the chance with the shotgun, just to find out? Alright, not too bad. I am going to No, I'm gonna do a normal fire. See if I can just weaken it a little. Okay, good. That should be flushing range. I could take the 54, but I want the higher chance to hit. Can we do it? There we go. Oh, wow, six. Heat ammunition does not care.
I'm rolling.
Heat ammunition does not even give a singular fuck. Alright, 21st Century Fool, you can begin to move back in with the team.
Running.
And at this point, since it is a crash, I am going to start moving in.
Roger. Tracking.
I do want to have Scoopy meet up with Lube Stapler in a moment. So, Scoopy, why don't you run down here? Lube Stapler, I'm gonna keep you where you are. Please heal up Scoopy.
Don't move, you'll be fine.
Good, good. Alright, and now Scoopy. Do me a favor and move up to here. Alright. Monty, you are going to move down here. And reload your weapon. And now we're gonna start thinking. I think I just reloaded the pistol. That's okay. For once, that's not a big deal. Karma Castaway, reload your sniper rifle, please. Sean Devlin. Also take a reload. This is the reload round. 21st Century Fool. You're going over there. And you're overwatching. Joe Z. Coffin Jack. Don't want to lead with Coffin Jack at all. We'll just stay where we are. Be a steadied weapon. Let's put Joe on the other side of this tree. This will be an overwatch. Actually, no, this will be a reload. And, okay, we can hear him. Can we start to see him? Well, let's get the right weapon out for starters. And let's blow a motion tracker charge. We've got... Okay, we've got him on motion tracker.
Okay.
Oh, he's just on the other side of that wall. Alright. Reload in place. I know, terrible positioning for a reload. What can you do? I'm gonna put Karmic Castaway over here. And now we do not want to engage on this turn because we don't want Monty to be standing out there like that.
I see you, Commander.
So,
moving to position.
We're just going to do a little bit of this.
Overwatch.
Now, unfortunately, this means we're probably not going to have enough targets for one of our rookies to get a kill.
Yes, sir.
If we do get a chance, we're going to try to prioritize Coffin Jack. Scoopy, I'm going to have you move to here. Good. Joe... Overwatch in place. Oh! More Seekers. Here they come. Two misses. Looked like three Seekers. Alright. Here they come. Here comes more reaction fire. We did get a couple of hits in. Good. Alright. Oh! And Josie gets another reaction shot. But Josie misses. Okay. Alrighty. Let's take stock of what we're up against. Josie is flanked, but Josie can move. 54. Josie can only see one of them. So we need to reposition around this tree, basically. Sean Devlin can potentially move in and grenade. 21st Century Fool has two shots. Coffin Jack has all three shots. And a 51 to hit that guy. 55 on him. Yeah, let's go for the 55. Might be able to end this guy right here. Close. Good try. Scoopy has a 63. I can move Scoopy and try and get a better shot. Joe Z can move to here and probably get a pick of any of the three of them. Or, you know, two of them. 54, 54. Flush, 84, 84. We're going to take the 84 on this guy. That should end him. Good. 21st Century Fool. Who do you have a look at? You have a 51 on him. You can move up just slightly. And that brings it up to 54. But you won the coin toss. Enjoy your promotion. Welcome to the ranks. Now, Scoopy, I'm going to bring to here. No such shot. Lube stapler. You got a 44. Might as well take it now. Actually, this guy is a threat. This guy has full health.
Damn it, I missed the target.
You sure did. And I don't think we want to do that. Can't quite reach him with a grenade. So this will be an overwatch. This will be an overwatch. And this will be simply getting into cover. Unfortunately, our tank is very, very far away. And to run over there is to invite the outsider. Karmic Castaway, you can't see anything. He's in a weird line of sight. So I'm going to have you move up to here. Fortunately, that still doesn't give sight, but alright, he overwatches. That gives us a free round of shots at him. And he can see up to here. This probably pulls an outsider. Let's see. I want holo targeting on this guy. Let's try going to here.
Heading there now.
Here comes the lightning reflexes.
Taking fire over here.
That's fine. And that's what we were trying to avoid. Monty's going hunting. Okay, well.
Clever girl.
Clever girl indeed. Clever girl, I like it. Alright. We can either fire or leave Scoopy flanked or move. Well, now that we don't have to worry about that anymore.
Solid copy.
This is likely, I think I can grenade that. That's only a tangential hit. I can airburst and hit him. Come on, give me that grenade back. Alright, I can airburst and hit him. I don't think this really takes out any cover because those things are indestructible. Where's Joe? Alright. Coffin Jack, I want you to roll up. Okay. You got a 50. Let's see. You can see both. Joe, I want you to roll up to here.
Will do.
That gives you visual on him. Here's what we're gonna do. Can I get... Alright, I can get Monty in there for... Okay, yeah, he's toasted. He's all done. If nothing else, we know we can do that. Alright. Let's get a holo target on this Seeker. Unfortunately, it's also a miss.
Damn it, missed the target.
Sure did. Let's give it a flush. Absolutely ruins him. Man, that armor-piercing ammo is amazing. Alright. I'm gonna throw the grenade with Sean Devlin just to see if it does anything. If it opens him up, then our rookies can take this guy out. If it doesn't open him up, Monty can finish him. Did it take him out of his cover? It looks like it did. What do we got now? 80% chance to hit. Excellent. Alright. We might not even need to do this. 87 and 50 to crit. Let's see. Can I get a shot with 21st Century Fool? Yes, I can. The idea here is I want to try and get... there's too many chances to crit here. Coffin Jack should fire first. Okay, Coffin Jack, he's yours to kill. But if you miss, you know, I can't do anything about that. 21st Century Fool, he's yours to kill. Or yours to weaken.
Dead in the water here, Commander.
Lube Stapler, he's yours to kill. Done and done.
Another day. Another successful operation.
I have no idea what that last phrasing was, but not bad. Operation Devil's Dream, 8 contacts, 7 of which were Seekers. So, not too bad. Glad we had the heat. Joe Z making up for lost time. Let's go ahead and get back and take a look at how we did.
Soldiers have to be feeling good after a mission like that.
So I'm actually kind of impressed, even though he did not get a kill. Coffin Jack has been promoted, as well as Karmic Castaway, 21st Century Fool, and Scoopy. No promotions for Joe Z, which is a shame because Joe Z did most of the work. Lube Stapler, Sean Devlin wasn't even close, and I don't think Monty Payson was very close. Let's take a look at what we got here. Alright, this is the big perk. Scoopy is our first scout that has to make the big perk decision. And considering the setup, I'm thinking it's possibly going to be concealment. Hit and run is a good one. Scoopy is not built for in the zone. Scoopy would not be able to do enough damage to accurately use in the zone. It's either going to be hit and run or concealment. I'm going to need to think on it. Karmic Castaway. Lone Wolf. Karmic Castaway is being built to be the long-range sniper. Precision shot will be next. 21st Century Fool, I need to think about. Coffin Jack, I need to think about. We have 9 Illyrium, 27 Alien Alloys, 1 Weapon Fragment, that must have been from the Outsider, 16 Meld, which isn't bad, 2 damaged computers, 1 damaged power source, and 7 Seeker Wrecks. Let's go sell off the broken stuff. Welcome to Crazy Zero's Broken Equipment Wholesale Emporium. Everything must go. All right. I'm not good at sales pitching. Okay, so we have 140 bucks. I wanted to spend it on something. Oh, right. I think I wanted a satellite, right? Build items. I need a little bit more money for a satellite. But I also need to build a satellite nexus in order to use that satellite. So, what are we looking at for a nexus? 40 engineers, which we're not up to yet. 300 bucks. 40 engineers, huh? How many do I have right now? 39. Okay, so I'm close. And actually, if you'll excuse me for just a moment, I will be right back. Alrighty, and we're back. So, here's the deal. I need 300 bucks for a satellite nexus. I've got 140. I could sell meld to get 2 more scientists. I have 512 meld. Oh wait, scientists. I don't need scientists, I need engineers. Never mind. Belay that order. One thing that we are not going to belay though is it's been a little while since we've scanned for Exalt. What day is it? Oh, it's only the 3rd. I think we can get away a little bit longer. Let's scan for activity. Everybody comes back. All right, that was a flurry of activity. Let me just take a look at something real quick. So, let's take a look at the hologlobe. All right, we now have operational satellites in Asia. Are our aircraft back? Yes, and Raven 10 has arrived too, so let's find out who Raven 10 is. Splinter Singh, welcome. I have one laser cannon that I can distribute. Let's see. Laser cannon up in 3 days. Avalanche missile, stinger missile. Laser cannon, stingray missile. I'm thinking... That laser cannon needs to be on somebody, and it needs to be on somebody now. Lieutenant Rechkolov has one, so that's two over there. We have more satellites over here. I am going to give it to Hawker. Okay. So that increases Hawker's downtime, but it keeps us from having to take an aircraft out of service to get that laser cannon. Let's keep rolling. Contact detected. Oh, well, they're wasting no time, aren't they? High fighter. Let's see. Flight Officer Singh, you're not going to be good for this one. Wolfram would be good. Sakai is good. Alright, I'm going to go up... I'm going to go up balanced with Sakai. If I can do enough damage to it, I can pull out and finish with Wolfram. Here we go. We just put these satellites up. We're very proud of them. We're not letting you shoot them down. Here we go.
Nearing strike.
All right. Come on, hit him again. One more. Get out.
We're getting eaten up here.
All right.
Contact.
So, let's see. Sakai's out for 17 days, which is not as bad as I thought it was going to be. We have Rechkolov in 3. In the meantime, Psycho Wolfram, bring this guy down. Show him why you're called Psycho. Hey, Tudo's back. Alright, bring him down, bring him down, bring him down. Come on. Come on, one more. One more. Get out. Shit. I need more laser cannons. It's most likely failed its mission. We're gonna leave it alone. Let's scan it. Alloy bipod. I actually think I want to build another laser cannon. Oh wait, no, we got another one in two more of them in 4 days. I don't need to build more laser cannons. Okay. Let's scan. Sectoid corpses for a scientist. That's a lot of sectoid corpses for one scientist, but it is Russia. I will think about it. We're not doing it right now. Are you still up here? Are you leaving? You're leaving, okay.
Excavation complete.
Alright. Shame we didn't shoot that fighter down, but you know, it is what it is. Alright, so that was building out this. Can I get some cash back by not... Well, I can only get a little bit of cash back by not excavating. I'm gonna let that go through. Gene lab. I need 200 bucks for a genetics lab. Yeah. I need 200 bucks for a genetics lab. What can I sell? Well, for starters, I'm gonna cancel this. That gave me back 20. And let's see. I think I can still pay for things in Illyrium. I have an awful lot of it. Let's see. Yeah, I could also pay for it in Seeker Rex. We're getting a lot of them lately. Alright, let's get rid of some of this. Let's get rid of some of this.
This new technology is incredible.
That should be plenty.
Weapons in particular. I don't know what we're going to do with this stuff once the aliens are gone.
We're probably going to destroy ourselves. We're probably definitely going to freaking destroy ourselves. Alright, engineering. Build me. Well, let's see, how long on mechs? 5 days on mechs. I'm gonna be weird and hold the cash. Yep. We have Carapace armor. Carry on.
Contact detected.
Nap of the Earth abductor. That is not worth sending. Like, Turnbull could maybe have a chance against it. But it's an abductor. I think it's better to just let this thing do what it's gonna do.
Commander, our failure to respond to the latest UFO contact is sure to displease the Council.
Not...
One of our top priorities is to maintain satellite coverage over the Council's member nations.
Jeez, Bradford. Calm down. There's a method to my madness.
Commander, we have multiple reports of new abductions in progress. The locations are marked on the hologlobe.
So Bradford, you're all bent out of shape about me not engaging the big-ass, nasty spacecraft in the air with my expensive interceptors that would probably die to prevent them from a light abduction in Merida, Mexico. Well, that's going to be our next mission. We're going to go thwart that on the ground with our advantage of having really well-trained troops. But that will be next episode. If you liked this episode, please click the like button. If you would like to be notified of future episodes, please consider subscribing. As usual, good things happen when you subscribe to the channel. But that has been it for this one. I have been Mark Zero. We will see you on the next operation. Have a good one.